Hello students, so let us discuss about time series input model. So under this particular topic, I am going to tell you about today the AR1 model and EAR model 1. So let us go for the definition of time series input model. So time series input model is a sequence of random variables, so that is represented by x1, x2, x3, xn. So it is said to be time series if x of i or x are identically distributed. So identically distributed is nothing but the normal, the x variables are normally distributed, and also it can be a time series if the random numbers are dependent. So the dependency of the random variables, how we are going to test that, we already we have done in the previous slide. So that you had certain test date, means the previous problems, if you are seeing the lead and demand time problem, we had a particular value for rho was equal to 0.851. So that gives you an idea of whether the two variables you have taken, that is x and y, are independent or dependent. So since the value was very near to 1, 0.851 is very near to 1, so we considered it as a dependent variable. Suppose the number variable was equal to 0, then we consider it as an independent variable. So if the rho value, depending on the rho value, you decide whether the variables are independent or dependent. So here we are considering the time series if the random variables are dependent. So in this case, the covariance, or it is represented by COV. So covariance of xt comma xt plus h is called lag h, auto covariance, and rho suffix h, that is equal to correlation of xt comma xt T plus H. So that is called autocorrelation here. So what is the definition of covariance? So let us see that. If the covariance depends only on the value of H and not on T, then the time series is said to be covariance stationary. And covariance stationary time series are of two types. So there are two models under this we are going to study. That is AR1 model and EAR1 model. So AR1 model has certain formulas, and EAR also has certain formulas. So AR1 model, so it is also a autoregressive order 1 model, and EAR model is also called as exponential autoregressive order 1 model. So in short form, we write it as AR1 and EAR1 models. So what, let us see the AR1 model. How to write this particular model. So this model is given by xt. So what is xt? Xt is equal to mu plus phi into xt minus 1 minus mu plus epsilon t, where t is equal to 2, 3, 4, like this it goes on. So where epsilon t is normally distributed over 0 comma sigma square a. So where and also phi is equal to rho, and also mu is equal to x bar. So what is meant by mu? Mu representation is for mean, and here mainly when you are writing epsilon t is normally distributed over 0 comma sigma square e. So here 0 is the value of mean, and sigma square is nothing but the variance. So next is EAR1 model. So in this model, it is given by, or this model is given by xt value. So xt value is will be equal to phi xt minus 1 with probability phi. And also one more value you are going to write, that is phi xt minus 1 plus epsilon t with probability 1 minus 5. So previous one, if it is 5, then you next value here you are going to write 1 minus 5, and t is equal to 2, 3 and 4, where 5 is equal to rho. So how initially you know how to calculate rho, okay? You have to know the formula to calculate the rho also before writing this phi value, by because phi is equal to rho here. So that means you have to get in the calculations, you have to get the value of rho before substituting this in this particular formula. So take a note here, that is, if rho is the positive value, so suppose after calculations you get a rho value as positive value, then you have to choose EAR1 model. And suppose rho value is negative, after calculations you get rho value as negative value, then you have to choose AR1 model. So that is the point to be noted here. Consider the following interarrival time as 1.95, 1.75, 0.58, 1.42, 1.28, 1.15, 1.04, 0.93, 0.84, 0.75, 0.68, 0.61, 11.98, 10.79, 9.71, 14.02, 12.62 and 11.36, 10.22 and 9.2. Consider the following interarrival time as 1.95, 1.75, 0.58, 1.42, 1.28, 1.15, 1.04, 0.93, 0.84, 0.75, 0.68, 0.61, 11.98, 10.79, 9.71, 14.02, 12.62 and 11.36, 10.22 and 9.2. Find an input model for this particular problem. So you have to find whether the input model is AR1 model or EAR1 model. So let us see the formula for covariance. Covariance is equal covariance of two variables, that is given as xt comma xt plus 1 is equal to 1 divided by n minus 1 summation of xt into xt plus 1 minus n into x bar t into x bar t plus 1. So this is the formula to find covariance. So let us see how to substitute the values for this particular formula. So we know that n value you want. So how many data are given? If you count here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So 20 data is given. So that is why n is equal to 20. So if you substitute that particular thing in this particular formula, it becomes 1 divided by n minus 1, that is 20 minus 1 is equal to 19. And next, you have to calculate xt into xt plus 1. How to calculate this particular xt and xt plus 1? So what you have to do is here, you have to multiply the first variable with the next variable, add that with the second variable and the third variable, again add it, and next you have to multiply with third variable into fourth variable, like this. So what it happens here is 1.95 into 1.75 plus 1.75 into 1.58 plus 1.58 into 1.42 plus 1.42 into 1.28 plus 1.28 into 1.15 plus 1.15 into 1.04 plus 1.04 into 0.93 plus 0.93 into 0.84 plus 0.84 into 0.75. So like this, you have to do this particular procedure up to this value, that is you have to do for it for all the 20 values. So you will be getting the value for summation of xt into xt plus 1. So when you add up all that values, you will be getting the value as 924.105. okay, So next is you have to subtract this with n into xt bar into xt plus 1. So that is n here is 20. Next is you need to calculate x bar t. So x bar t formula is summation of xi divided by n. Okay, I have written here. So x bar value, that is x bar, so that is equal to when you add up all the x values or x variables, okay, that means from 1.95 to 9.2, you'll be getting it as 103.88 divided by n. N is 20 because 20 data is given, so that's why 20, you get it as 5.194. so this is the x bar value, okay, or x bar t value. So here if you substitute it, so what is x bar t into x bar t plus 1? So that is x square, okay, so it becomes 5.194 whole square. So we got all the values for this particular formula, is it? So I have substituted here, and you will be get, if you calculate this value, you'll be getting it as 20.24. So next thing is we need to calculate rho. What is rho? Rho is covariance of xt comma xt plus 1 sigma xt into x sigma xt plus 1. So always covariance formula is same, covariance of two variables we are finding. So that is we have studied this particular formula in the previous slide. So that same formula we have used here. Instead of x we have written xt, and instead of y we have written xt plus 1. So that same thing is written here, that is rho value. So to calculate rho value, you need covariance of xt comma xt plus 1. So that is, you have got it already in this particular formula, that is 20.24. and what you need is sigma xt into sigma xt plus 1. So next thing is sigma xt and xt plus 1 is sigma square. So that's why that is equal to summation of x square minus n into x bar square divided by n minus 1. So if you write it, I have written this particular same formula again here, and if you substitute that, so calculate sigma square value, you get it as 1046.57. okay, so next is minus n. N is 20 into sigma x bar square. So x bar value is 5.194, so that if you square it, it is x bar square. So that's why 5.194 whole square we have written here, divided by n minus 1. N is 20, 20 minus 1 is 19. So that's what we have written here. So how do you calculate this summation of x square? So what you have to do is, to find summation of x square value, you need to square these values, that is 1.95. So initial x value it is, okay, or x high value, is it? So that is why 1.95 whole square plus 1.75 whole square plus 1.58 whole square, like this. You have to do it for all the variables over here. These 20 variables they have given you, all everything you have to square it and add it, so that you get summation of x square value. Okay, so I have written here one to show, just to show few values I have written here, but you have to do it for all the values from 1.95 to 9.2. that is, you have to square each and every number in this particular thing. 1.95 square plus 1.75 square plus 1.58 square plus 1.42 square plus 1.28 square, like this you have to continue up to this value, that is 9.2 whole square. Okay, so that is the summation value of x square values you got as 1046 46.57. So after you complete this, you'll be getting the value as 26.68. So you got covariance value and also sigma square value. So that you can calculate rho value. Rho, what is rho? Rho is covariance of xt comma xt plus 1 divided by sigma xt into x sigma xt plus 1. So that is 20 plus 24 divided by 26.68. So 26.24 you got it from here. Next value you got it from here. So that is what you are going to do, and you will be getting be calculating, and you will be getting it as 0.75. So you got the value as 0.75. So this is what rho value. So already we have said depending on the rho value, you are going to choose one of the model, that is maybe it may be a AR model or EAR model. So rho value is 0.75. So that is positive value. Rho value, if it is positive value, you are going to choose EAR1 model. If rho value is negative, then you are going to choose AR1 model. So since the value of rho is positive value, because 0.75 is a positive value, you are going to choose EAR1 model. So they based on the chosen model, you are going to write the formula for EAR1 model. So that is xt is equal to phi of xt minus 1 with probability phi, and phi of xt minus 1 plus epsilon t with probability 1 minus phi, where phi is equal to rho. Okay, so whatever rho value you get it here will be so using that EAR1 model formula, xt can be written as xt is equal to phi of, that is here phi value, phi into xt minus 1. Okay, what is phi? Phi is 0.75, you got it from calculation, with probability 0.75. okay, this is phi value we have written as 0.75. and next thing is, in the second row you are going to write phi of xt minus 1 plus epsilon t. So what is phi? Phi value got it as 0.75 with probability. Here the formula is 1 minus phi. 1 minus phi means 1 minus 0.75. That is equal to, you get it as 0.25. So that is what you have substituted it in the form. In this particular formula, we have got the value like this. So this is our required model. So which model you are going to select is EAR1 model. So this is the final answer for the problem.